Hi everyone, this is Nick, and in today's quick video, I'm going to talk about survey sampling and margins of error. So in my world, I do a lot of visitor experience surveys for places like museums, zoos, aquariums. We often want to survey our visitors and ask them how we are doing as an organization. What was their overall experience like? And so from this example here, I have 1,000 potential people in my population. These are the people that visited our museum throughout the year. Now in reality, we know this number is probably a lot larger, probably hundreds of thousands, maybe even millions of visitors, but I'm just going to use 1,000 as my example today. So we have 1,000 people that we could potentially survey from. So I go out into the museum, and over a random sampling of days throughout the year, I approach every third visitor that I see, and I ask them to complete a survey. This is one of the ways that we would, as randomly as possible, select visitors for our survey sample. So let's just say after the year goes by, I was able to collect 100 surveys from a random sample of these visitors. So there are my 100 visitors that I got surveys from in blue. Now, I want to be able to calculate a margin of error because anytime we sample, we know that there's going to be some uncertainty in that data. The response that we get from these 100 people may not be the same response that we get from another set of 100 people. So we want to calculate that margin of error. And one way that we do that is by going over to a margin of error calculator. We like to use the American Research Group calculator here. I'm going to enter my population size of 1,000, and then I'm going to enter my sample size of 100, and we're going to calculate the error. It's 9.3%. So what that means is that there's a 9.3% margin of error on either side of the result that I get from my survey sample. So let's just go ahead and say that of the 100 people that I was able to sample, 75% of them said that they were satisfied with their visit. Now, going by that margin of error calculator that we just did, let's round up a little bit and say 10%. So that means that if I were to go out, or that means that the survey margin of error would give me a range between 65% and 80%. So the actual value that I would receive is probably within that range somewhere, that 20% range. Now, what if I go out and I sample another 100 visitors in my population? Not the same visitors, a different group of 100, that means that we've got a 95% chance that the result of the number of visitors here who were satisfied should be within plus or minus 10% of that 75 number that I got before. So in this case, 82% of this sample was satisfied with their visit. So this is one thing that we really need to think about when we're surveying our visitors, this level of uncertainty, especially when we're creating goals like KPI level goals. We want 75% of our visitors to be satisfied with their visit. Well, at the end of the year, if we got a number below 75%, does that mean that we failed as an organization? Probably not, because statistically it falls within that margin of error. So in this case, if our goal is 75%, a value of 65%, 66%, that is lower than 75%, but it's within that confidence interval. It's within that margin of error. So statistically, we might be able to look at that 65 or 66% pretty much the same as 75%. So you've actually achieved your goal in that case. I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and tap the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a new data design tutorial in PowerPoint, Word, or Excel, or potentially some survey design and sampling tricks and tips along the way. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you next time.